Troy has asked, how much blowby is too much blowby? Is the best way to check by using a leak down tester? Okay, so really this question is a little bit hard to answer because it's going to depend on the particular engine. Remembering that our ring end gap is going to depend on the sort of engine we're building, whether it's naturally aspirated or turbocharged. And also when we're talking about turbocharged engines, we generally we will have more blowby. It's inevitable we're going to end up with that blowby. And as we increase the boost pressure, we increase the blowby level. So I wouldn't say there's such a thing as too much blowby. It's all about understanding and controlling that blowby, which is why in very high boost turbocharged engines, quite often there's a lot of work goes into increasing the size of the breathers from the rocker cover and the crankcase in order to evacuate that blowby out of the engine. There are a couple more things I'll add into this though. It is possible to measure blowby. There are actual gauges. It's not something I've used before. Something that I do incorporate in some of our high boost drag engines is a crankcase pressure sensor. So in a roundabout way, this kind of gives us an idea of how much blowby we've got. And what we can do is use that to monitor the engine health. So if we've got data from that pressure sensor when the engine was freshly built, we can watch as the ring seal starts to deteriorate and as our blowby increases, and that pressure sensor will tell us when the engine is starting to suffer a little bit there. By using a leak down tester, as you've also commented there, leak down testers or compression testers and leak down testers are really powerful tools. A compression tester will give you a rough idea of the seal inside a cylinder. However, it's not going to tell you where the problem lies if you are low in compression. A leak down tester, on the other hand, can allow you to very specifically pinpoint whether the leakage is coming back past the valves, maybe into the water jacket, into the cooling system through a head gasket leak, or also down past the ring. So that'll give you an idea if your ring seal is problematic.
That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.